Today's video tries to give a new angle on an over-exploited ingredient, maybe slightly overhyped ingredient, hyaluronic acid. Do I like it, believe it, should you bet on it, and in case you do, what's the best way to take advantage from it? Skincare people, welcome back to the channel. If it's your first time, welcome. If you were a regular, welcome two times even more intensive as the second. No, my name is Custodio, and here at DH Traveler, I try every week to ask the question, what is that skin wanted before marketing got in the way? So today, hyaluronic acid. So let's try to get this right from the very beginning. Hyaluronic acid doesn't start as a filler, as a skincare ingredient. To understand it right, it starts as skin, something that the skin produces itself. And if we understand skin before we try to understand ingredients and products and brands philosophies, we always get to a better place. So this is my belief, for you to know exactly how to use hyaluronic acid, you need to spend some time understanding what it is. So when we say hyaluronic acid, we say matrix, we say connective tissue, we say that cushion, which is dermal, so under the epidermis, where you have the collagen, the elastin, so all those elastic fibers, they should be hydrated, they should be elastic, because if they dry out, they break down. And that's what hyaluronic acid is doing. So it's the water captor, it's the water in the mattress, matrix, mattress, whatever you want. So this is the first thing to conclude, is that hyaluronic acid, it's a water retenter, it's hygroscopic, it's an humectant, whatever makes more sense for you. But the question, valid question, is, does this water capture generate its own water? And the answer is no, it doesn't. It doesn't generate its own water in the body, in the skin, as it doesn't in skincare. So let's try to understand together that if you are walking about your city with a humectant called flashy hyaluronic acid, that's a humectant. So it's capturing, it's taking the water and holding the water. If the city you walk about is, let's say, Kuala Lumpur, so the capital of Malaysia, which is very humid, which is warm most of the year, a very high level of atmosphere humidity, then your hyaluronic acid has a lot of humidity to capture and to hold. But if you walk in a city or in the desert and there is no water around you, if you are flying inside aircraft, the level of humidity, it's very low. So whenever the atmosphere around you, it's less of a humid atmosphere, hyaluronic acid will start trying to draw water, then not from outside, but from inside. So the message most important to understand hyaluronic acid is that in the mix of a well-balanced skincare, it can do more water retention than maybe any other ingredient. But if you bet on it as the sole source of hydration, you are doing it wrong, because biology rules, your skin rules. So the way this molecule was created by nature is to constantly be trying to capture humidity, regardless where the humidity is coming from. So it might be outside, you steal it from the atmosphere, or it is stealing it from you. So it's a perfect example to understand ingredients, not as a standalone ingredient, but a perfect mix in a good recipe for skincare. So let's try to give practical advice, the best way to use hyaluronic acid. So rule number one, I think it's to apply hyaluronic acid products, which are very high on hyaluronic acid, when the product is promising hyaluronic acid power and action, you should apply it on a slightly damp skin to begin with, so that there is moisture to immediately start to hold and having that sponge, biological sponge effect. That's why, in terms of product application, the best products with hyaluronic acid should be essences, toners, but even more so should be serums. That's the one place where, personally, in my brand Swiss line, we formulate with more active forms of hyaluronic acid. If you are one of those skincare psychos who like to do a lot and many, many steps, you can actually have a spray of mineral water, the typical Evian mineral water, sprayed on your face just before or just after applying your serum with hyaluronic acid. That's an intelligent step, not saying by no means that this is essential and that you cannot live without, but if you like to add those steps, those experiences, if you like to spend more time in front of the mirror doing interesting things about skincare, I mean, last week I was just sending my dogs, if you haven't seen the video, it's here, about what I consider bad advice. One of the things I was saying is that I don't really believe so much in a lot of gadgets and a lot of, but sometimes these additional steps like hyaluronic acid plus a mineral water spray could be interesting. Then, by the same token, immediately after applying hyaluronic acid, you should not wait long and long for applying your moisturizer. Because remember, it's not generating its own water, it's a water capture, so you want that water to be held on your skin, so your moisturizer will always have, regardless what the formulation is, not only humectants, but more occlusive sort of elements. I mean, they can come from very different sources. You can have ingredients, when we talk about products, products which also contain ceramides, NMF. So all these elements likely present in your moisturizer will help to seal and to guarantee that you are keeping the water your hyaluronic acid is capturing. By the same means, if your day is very dry, if you feel that you are in a more dry environment, or dry environment can also be indoors with strong heating, with strong air conditioning. So if this is your reality, hyaluronic acid is much more your friend during the night than during the day. So if you're a friend of the channel, I'm sure by now you are surprised how come he didn't start already with his inky lists and his lists of ingredients we can find in the box to detect the ingredient. Okay, so the waiting is over. Let's do it. Names which mean hyaluronic acid can come, of course, as hyaluronic acid. This is the more bioidentical material. Does it mean it is the best? Well, really depends on the rounded formula and the objective you want to reach. But hyaluronic acid in the pure form, it's altering a lot. The consistency of the formula can only be used in somewhat limited concentrations, normally around 1%, rarely above that, and hyaluronic acid has the advantage to stay very much on the skin surface. So the same way like collagen, when it's the pure thing, so collagen is the protein, hyaluronic acid is a mucopolysaccharide, it's not a protein, but still has a very high molecular weight, so it cannot penetrate. So I like hyaluronic acid as a pure ingredient, just as a surface line filler, and used together with other forms of humectant. As a sole humectant, if it stays so much on the surface, it's not exactly the best way to do it. But of course, if it's associated to as simple glycerin for humectant, then we are good to go. Second, and maybe 99% of the products claiming hyaluronic acid, they will contain not hyaluronic acid in the inky, but sodium hyaluronate, which is the sodium, so the salt form of hyaluronic acid. It already has a lower molecular weight, so it can penetrate a bit deeper into the skin. Associating both, it's another way to go, so you can have the two together in one same formula. Again, sodium hyaluronate also cannot go as much more than 2% in the formulation, because otherwise your gel emulsion serum becomes too solid, too thick to be aesthetically pleasant. So no brands really risk to go higher than 2%. But at these levels, you already have a very good water retention effect. Then we come to maybe the most exciting forms, which are hydrolyzed forms. So either hydrolyzed hyaluronic acid or hydrolyzed sodium hyaluronate. And these are more multi-molecular weight formulations, which enable a better mix, so taking the best results from a deeper water retention. When I say deeper, I'm saying still epidermis. None of these will reach the dermis the same way the collagen. If you're curious about collagen, there is also plenty of videos. I'm just linking one here. We spoke extensively because I'm keen on collagen. I think it's a misunderstood ingredient for the same reason that now I'm trying to highlight the qualities and the limitations of hyaluronic acid. None of them are really going to penetrate deep enough to replenish our reserves either of collagen or hyaluronic acid, but they can complete signaling repair and work as superficial, beautiful, beautiful plumpers and line fillers to convey more elasticity. And because I don't understand skincare as a sole ingredient story, I think the role of skincare, exciting skincare, it's more complex, rounded formulations. I know that part of the industry, it's going sole ingredient in very high concentration. Time will tell if that is the best way to go. I think the best way to go is to mix some of those that your skin needs with well-rounded formulas which replicate the biology of skin. And the biology of skin, it's not one sole cell, protein, sugar, enzyme. It's the cascade, the very complex dominoes effects between all of them. Skin, it's not one thing separated from the others. They all function in synergy. Then you can also find something interesting, which is sodium hyaluronate cross polymer. So polymers being more produced in lab type of molecules where you can alter the behavior of the molecule in terms of penetration, spreadability, etc., etc. So these cross polymers can also facilitate a lot the good water retention capacity with limiting the penetration. So for those which could be concerned about hyaluronic acid drawing skin moisture out of your skin, with the sodium hyaluronate cross polymer, this is probably the less likely case. So I believe in all these. And by the way, I don't know if you realize that this is a perfect formula pyramid video, those of you which are friends with the channel, and I've announced recently the end of the series. Some of you just mentioned to me by email that I have skipped hyaluronic acid. It makes my day, honestly, it really touches me that some of you are paying attention to the channel, that you could spot that I had skipped the hyaluronic acid video. There was absolutely no reason to do it. Something got, like so many times in life, in the way. So whatever happened, which I cannot even recall, made me miss that. So that's why the video is here. The series is still closed, but you see, never say never, I owe the pyramid this video. So which are my favorites? As always tradition, I always begin with my Swiss line, CellShock Age Intelligence, the source booster, so the fountain booster, which contains 1.5% hyaluronic acid. We talk about the hydrolyzed version, a version with a polymer that is also called micro sponges. So you have these very grafted, very good penetration and water retention from inside out. Of course, not to be used alone, that's why it's a booster. It's to be added to your serum, to your moisturizer. So what I explained about the film, the occlusive, locking it, you can just from first step while mixing it in your skincare, you can have already that benefit. And because we think pyramid also in the product development, what is added to the hyaluronic acid? NMF, ATP, so water and energy to make this source a real source of benefits without any drawback. From Medicaid, Hydrate B5, they have the old formula, which is basically sodium hyaluronate alone with a few other ingredients, but this works therefore just more as a water retainer, not so much the plumpness. To have that real plumping effect, you need those cross polymers and those hydrolyzed forms that I mentioned. More recently, Hydrate B5 Intense, it's a much better formula. I by far prefer to the original formula because here you have, in addition to the hyaluronic acid, the ceramides, the NMF, you have soy, a good hydrolyzed soy form, which also, if you're curious about soy, here a video, which is a recent video. Soy is very dear to my heart. and I believe it's a very good source of benefits. Also, I like to see it in Medicaid, this intense version. It's very functional level, and soy together with the hyaluronic acid, it's also quite a good mix. Paula's Choice, the mix between, so their hyaluronic acid booster, the mix between the pure hyaluronic acid and the sodium hyaluronate, even better in my book, the ultralight superoxidant serum. So this is the ultralight, but there is also the concentrate version, so combination to oily skin. The concentrated version is basically the same formula, but then of course with an added more nourishing face. Here you have the hydrolyzed I mentioned together with the pure hyaluronic acid, so more forms of hyaluronic acid. In my eyes, compared to the hyaluronic acid booster, here you have more rounded ingredients, so more benefits, still with a very performing level of hyaluronic acid. So what about mature skins and those skins which want to address the signs of aging? So not only dryness, dehydration, but actively address the signs of aging. I will mention for the first time in the channel, I believe the first time, I'm not saying it's the last, but it's not going to be very often, Estée Lauder Advanced Night Repair. The reason why, it's simply because it tends to be too much generic, in simple words, all over the place skincare, in my opinion. But Advanced Night Repair, not the classic Advanced Night Repair in this case, but the Reset Concentrate, Intense Reset Concentrate. It's and that's the reason why I got curious about it. It has the cross polymers, the hydrolyzed version, so a very complex molecule of hyaluronic acid, together with their RNI and their Advanced Night Repair probiotic Bifida ferment, so the classic antioxidant from the Advanced Night Repair series. And really a very interesting way to include hyaluronic acid together with the antioxidants and cellular repair. So I would say a more mature skin option. So in this case, hyaluronic acid in complex forms with other anti-aging ingredients. Back to Swiss line, hyaluronic acid together with collagen. So the 360 degree serum, the idea here, we have one for face, one for eyes. We are again, of course, with these two on the higher price level. But I still have one affordable surprise to close the video. Connecting hyaluronic acid and collagen, I think it's also pyramid philosophy. The best way to go to have the plumping, the water retention, the elasticity, because the two together in skincare mirror the two together in dermal matrix and dermal connective tissue. Don't forget, they are born together, they grow together, they get old together in skin. So if you replicate that in skincare, for sure it makes sense. So why am I talking about these? Is because our product contains these? No, it's the other way around. Our product contains these because I'm talking about these, because I believe in these, and that's our point of view in R&D. So I promise to close with the more affordable version of all, and this is Adalabo, the classic Japanese Adalabo, which is an emporium, gigantic manufacturer in Japan, which supplies the whole world with hyaluronic acid, different forms of hyaluronic acid molecules. That's why they can keep their prices so affordable, because this is exactly what they do. It's their DNA. It's to formulate and develop hyaluronic acid. So their essences, this is a limited edition with a Snoopy, but that's not the way the product normally looks. They also make available refills, so this bottle is no longer the hyaluronic acid normal version. They have various collections, always with the essence. To me, that's the one product which you should explore. So they have the normal hyaluronic acid multi-molecular weight essences. You have the brightening one, the blue line, where hyaluronic acid is associated to tranexamic acid, which is beautiful for pigmentation, post-inflammatory pigmentation, redness, an ingredient which we also use in Swiss line. And then you have the gold line, where you have more omega, more nourishing for dry skin, the red line with the retinoid associated to hyaluronic acid. I would really say, if you are on a budget, or regardless if you are on a budget, but you want to have an essence, so that step after the cleansing, so you don't want, you already have too many serums, you have too many creams, you don't want to add another product with hyaluronic acid to your mix, you have a booster, or you have the step of essence to replace probably a more dull toner that you are using. If that's the case, this is a fantastic option. So I hope the video was useful. This video, which is in the series, out of the series. I always talk about my Thai because the video is already quite some long. I'm just showing the picture. That's a vintage Givenchy, still from the time of Robert Givenchy, so from the founder and creator. It's always good to see you. Leave comments below. Interact with the channel. If there are any topics that you would like me to talk about, please let me know. Love, take care, and as always, with hyaluronic acid or without it, but better with it, say no to boring skincare. Ciao, see you next week. Did you like the content? You think this is interesting? So why not to activate the bell, subscribe the channel, so we can see each other every week. I would be very happy.